So Ben was a youth pastor. How many years were you a youth pastor?
10 years.
10 years. And I'm a youth pastor right now. And so we love working with youth pastors, youth ministers, youth volunteers. And one thing that I know that we share in common is a real desire to see the youth we work with discipled. Mm-hmm. And the interesting thing is it's hard to disciple young people.
Really hard. In the last year with Alpha, we've been able to help about 8,000 churches around the world and youth ministries to reach out to about 300,000 youth. And the things that we're learning together are things that we're so excited to pass on.
Yeah, I guess the big thing we want to pass on today is this, that if you want to see Alpha disciple students in your youth ministry, the best way to do that is to position Alpha as something designed for people who are not currently in your youth ministry. I guess what I mean is position it in a way that is for people that wouldn't typically go to church, and engage the students in your ministry in inviting, praying for it, hosting tables, setting up the space, give them ownership, invite them into the mission. And what you'll see is that when you position it for people outside the church, that you'll see those that are already with you discipled even more.
So this is interesting because sometimes groups, they want to use Alpha for discipleship, and so they run it for their youth group first and not actually open it up and encourage everyone to invite their friends and not empower youth to be hosts and helpers at the tables or the groups. But the opposite happens actually. When we do position it evangelistically, that's the best discipleship. That there's an ownership that happens in the faith, and it changes, young people engage in a totally different way.
Yeah, that's what I found with my own journey. When I was in high school, some friends and I ran a discussion group like Alpha in our school for our friends that wouldn't typically go to church. And then what began to happen inside of me is when I heard the content through the lens of my non-Christian friends, and I saw God work in their lives, it did something in my heart that really laid the foundation for all the work that I'm doing today. And we also see this in the model of Jesus. This is how Jesus did ministry. He brought people along, and it was in that space that he was discipled.
So another thing that we've learned is that there's typically four models or ways that we see youth groups run Alpha. The first is with the whole group. You replace your weekly youth night, and they go big for a season, and they run Alpha.
And that's probably the most common.
Yeah, I think so. And that's, we would encourage people, if you've never done Alpha.
Yeah. Or that's like maybe the best way to introduce it is say, hey, do it, like maybe do a couple weeks leading up to it to get it, people excited, inviting their friends, and then boom, this is part of your regular youth night. Mm-hmm. And I gotta say something for my friends that do like worship music at their youth night, is you can keep that part of it. You just might think, okay, how do we explain this and set this up and pick songs that would be good for guests? Mm-hmm. Okay, tell them the second one.
Yeah, the second one would be, again, whole group, but it's actually decentralized. Small groups in homes, whether it's 3 or 30 spread out, but the whole group's going through Alpha, engaging, inviting their friends, and that's the second way. The third way.
Yeah, the third way is this idea of, in addition to your weekly youth program, having another slot in the week that could be before the youth group, after school, it could be a different night of the week, but it's a different spot. And so it's almost like this idea that you've always got a space where you can bring a new person or someone who might not typically go to church into that space like Alpha, where they can explore and ask questions. That's a good like onboard into the youth group. So we've seen that done really, really well. I guess the fourth way is the one that's most dear to my heart. And it's this idea of empowering students in their world to run with their friends. Empowering them in their world to run with their friends. It's that could be in a coffee shop or a restaurant or often in their home or even in their school when they have permission. And it's like they have full ownership. And what I love about this model is you see this off the ground really fast. And then as youth workers and youth volunteers, our role becomes like a coach. We're just coaching them along the way. I guess the big thing is this, whichever of those four models you decide to do or are doing, our encouragement would be position it for people who wouldn't typically go to church. Make it evangelistic. And second, empower youth throughout it.
Absolutely. And what you see is young people grabbing hold of their own faith in a deeper, more significant way. And we get to see young people who have never met Jesus introduced to him for the first time.
I love it.
So we love you guys. We're grateful for the work you're doing. We're praying for you. See ya.